Coming up next on ATETV. Industry partnerships.
We have very strong relationships with business and industry. What we're doing is we're exposing these companies to the community college.
Energy education.
People are starting to catch on to the importance of energy conservation.
And laser and photonics technology.
All those colors are in this.
Now on ATETV. From across the country to your own backyard, ATETV shows you the many advanced technological education opportunities available at your local community college. Community colleges have partnered with leaders in the computer industry to offer two-year programs to get students up and running in computer technology. These companies look to those graduates to meet their workforce demands. Take a look.
There are network engineers that run service provider and big enterprise networks actually sitting in here learning how to configure and program our products, both the security products, the routing products, and the switching products. Now, it's interesting to note about this, students from the community who are not network professionals can actually go and take this very class.
You're the web one.
We have very strong relationships with business and industry. What we're doing is we're exposing these companies to the community college.
So in the Juniper program, you're going to have to put in the route, a static route. Are you in Juniper?
Through the collaboration between industry and education, between Juniper and local colleges, they can access the same information to prepare themselves for the jobs that these very people have.
Like you don't see any routes for the stick network.
Okay. I'm working on actual Juniper routers. I'm dealing with actual real world items.
If you don't have a crossover cable, what you do is you put this in the middle.
We were able to get an equipment donation from Juniper Networks. We've also got a similar relationship with Cisco Systems, and we are now discussing a similar program with EMC.
My role is to work with colleges and universities to offer them a generic course on information storage and management.
Yeah. Okay, cool.
And hopefully they will decide to offer it as part of their computer science or IT programs.
Just do the network.
A lot of these programs through two-year colleges and technical schools can be really important because experience is actually a part of the classroom.
Joe, you and Juniper?
We've made good connections with these companies and they realize what great places community colleges are. Probably the first place they come now when they want to hire somebody new.
Because computer technology programs, like Springfield's, are designed with industry input, students get the real-world experience they need to start their careers the minute they graduate. For more information on computer technology programs near you, be sure to visit your local community college. With people becoming more aware of the environment and the high cost of energy, the demand for trained energy technicians has never been higher. Let's visit Sinclair Community College and take a look at the energy education program.
My name is Mike Traen. I'm with Certified Energy Raters.
You guys really crazy. It shouldn't be too hot.
The number on the left.
Over the window.
We are certified HERS Rater, so we do performance testing for ENERGY STAR compliance and labeling. We are also certified to do green build verifications for their program nationally.
Somebody get windows, somebody gets a side.
People are just now starting to catch on as to the importance of ENERGY STAR and energy conservation.
John, you want to go to the back side of the house, which is that would be the south.
The latest trend really is in the building science area, to where we're now looking at the home as an energy system rather than just the individual components. We're interested now finally in how the home as an energy system works together in conjunction with everything.
That's the model for this part, isn't it?
Yes.
It's not just the insulation, it's not the furnace. It's how do those things work well with one another, as well as the lighting and the other components to go into it.
As the fan speed increases, the building depressurization displayed on channel A should also increase.
There's not a day that goes by that we don't get new information. There's new ideas coming out.
Take a baseline building pressure.
There's just a great movement in this direction. It's just a way to be environmentally responsible is what it amounts to, and not using more than you have to, not disposing more than you have to.
It does. It asks for it.
It's a good thing for a homeowner because they're going to save money in the process.
The field of energy efficiency and compliance is going to expand, and that means the need for qualified energy technicians is only going to increase. If you think you might be interested in a career in energy efficiency, be sure to check out the programs being offered at your local community college. Thinking about going back to school? Want to start a new career working with cutting-edge technology in as little as 2 years? You might want to consider studying laser and photonics technology.
Is a strong, powerful laser. It'd be something that would damage you, or sticking your hand in there, it would burn you. My name's Andy Dawson. I'm a first-year student here at the Central Carolina Department campus for lasers and photonics. I did a year in college, and then I went into the workforce. I was a truck driver, so I decided I would go back to school.
We have a helium neon laser.
You got your basic clipper.
We can have either electricity or light.
That is them separating.
It stops at 45 amps. I am 30 years old, so I didn't want to spend a whole lot of time back in school, but I wanted to do a jump start on something to get back in the workforce. Think everything would jump up, but here that's the green that's got the highest visible, purple is blue that's got the highest infrared. It is a struggle. There's a lot of math involved, but I'm dealing with it fine. I'm maintaining right now. I've got a 3.1 grade point average.
If you climb it up clockwise, it would get stronger on both sides.
I had a choice between this and industrial maintenance, and when I came in here, I went and talked to Mr. Gary Beasley about it, and he kind of helped me push to get into the program. So, and there wasn't much pushing involved after he started talking about it. He sells it real well.
It's just fun. Always working on cutting edge, always working on something that no one else could see.
All those colors are in this.
I'm loving every minute of the program so far. I mean, anytime I get something in my hands and I'm having to deal with it and work on it and being able to break that laser down, when I get through with it and saying, hey, look, this is what's wrong with it, this is how to fix it, and it's working correctly now. I mean, that's what excites me about the program. From what I'm looking at, this is putting up the highest infrared. There it goes there. I mean, it's amazing that we could come into a community college and not have to spend all this money for a four-year degree and get maximum output from the program. And the pay is going to be just tremendous from what I've heard when I get out of here for what I'm putting into the program. For 2 years, I mean, you can't go wrong with that by any means.
Andy has it all figured out. He's getting a great, affordable education in an exciting field. And in just 2 years, he'll be starting a high-paying, high-tech career. To learn more about laser and photonics technology, or for more information on anything you've seen today, be sure to explore our website at ATETV.org. Thanks for watching.